What is up, guys? Welcome to another Home Free Friday. As always, enjoy the kind of content I'm putting out. Feel free to like, comment, subscribe down below, share with your friends, all that good stuff. But today, we've got something that I'm pretty excited for. I reacted to the gentleman of Home Free performing God Bless the USA with Lee Greenwood, if I'm not mistaken. And it sounded really good. It was well done, but I just kind of felt like Home Free was just kind of there as like a backing band, and it was really Lee Greenwood's song, and Home Free kind of got lost in the mix. And according to some of the comments, I was in the minority in thinking that, which is totally cool. I really respect everybody for respectfully voicing your opinions in the comments. But a lot of you also told me that they actually performed this song, just the five of them, way back in the day. Like, back before Chris was even there. Or no, I'm sorry, back before Chance was even there. And yeah, everybody told me that it might be a little bit more up my alley because it is just Home Free and not 20 other people. So yeah, I've kind of heard this song before, but I have a feeling that their arrangement here is going to be a lot different than their one that they released sometime in 2020. I could be wrong. It could sound the exact same. That would be very impressive if they were able to just create 20 other voices, but time will tell. But yeah, thank you all so much for watching. I really appreciate it, and let's go ahead and get into it.
If tomorrow all the things were gone I'd worked for all my life,
oh, Austin,
and I had to start again with just my children and my wife, I'd thank my lucky stars to be living here today, where the flag still stands for freedom, and they can't take that away. The man who died, who gave that right to me, and I'll gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee,
across the plains of Texas, oh, from sea to shining sea.
Oh, damn it, Tim.
From Detroit down to Houston and New York to LA, where there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say, the man who died, who gave that right to me, and I'll gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. Today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA.
Oh,
That was pretty good. That was pretty good. Oh my. Yeah, that was wonderful. That was all home free. And Chris sounded good. Like, Chris didn't take anything away from this arrangement, but I did feel like it was missing a little bit, not having Chance there. Feel like it could have used a little more on the bottom end during that last big harmony. But wow, this was really good. This was really everything that I wanted to see from this song that the other version kind of just left me wanting more. This was like the perfect companion to that track.
So first and foremost, I don't think I ever realized that Adam had long hair, like hair to the length where you would need to tie it back with a ponytail, which seems weird because I'm pretty sure I've seen their music videos dating back a long time, including the sing-off. God, I swear it's the first time I've seen him with a ponytail. But either way, aside from that, the actual song, it was excellent. It was a very simplistic arrangement, and it just fit this song perfectly. And it got big, and it got huge when it needed to. I just loved that nice, slow, ease you in intro. Oh man, it was beautiful. My favorite part though was probably when they were like rattling off all the states, like the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, and each person would take like one line or two lines with those like switching off those beautiful alternating harmonies into that four-part chorus where it was literally just a wall of sound. Like that 45 seconds or so, I got chills, like I got goosebumps. It was so beautiful and so well done. Oh, man. And good for Chris for arranging this as well. You know, way back in the day, first thing he ever arranged for Home Free. I mean, I'm glad that they have Chance. Chris is good. Chris is talented. But yeah, I love having that lower bass note in those big harmonies when you have Tim actually doing the bass line. Man. But yeah, other than that, fantastic. Adam, of course, with that little snare roll there at the end, just like in the other one, sounded just like he swallowed a fucking drum. Don't understand it. Will never understand it. He is probably the member of Home Free where, like, if I show this group to anybody, the first thing that they say is that they have a drum set. Like, nobody believes that the noises coming from the speaker are from a man and not from an actual instrument. Every single time, every time I introduce somebody to it, it's just stellar. It is so stunning. And with the other four amazing voices, it's no wonder that they are one of the most popular a cappella groups in the entire world. Oh man, they deserve it. They absolutely deserve it. And I love that it was shot at Mount Rushmore. It's a fun time if you go. It's a great way to spend a half hour, 45 minutes. But the Black Hills, there's all kinds of cool shit to do there in western South Dakota, but it's pretty much the only thing to do in that state. But I actually also filmed a video in front of Mount Rushmore, pretty much where Home Free is, which is pretty crazy. Definitely way better than the video that I recorded, but Home Free and I have used the same location for our respective videos, which is pretty wild to think about. But yeah, this was really good. I really enjoyed this version of this track. Hell yeah. Way to go, Home Free. But thank you all so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Please let me know what you thought down in the comments. Otherwise, have an excellent rest of your Home Free Friday, and I will see you in a reaction very soon.